I can tell you to a certain degree how this works. But it's such an ancient art form, and really that's just my very personal interpretation of what's actually going on. I won't unnerve you with some kind of esoteric mumbo jumbo here about energies and stuff like that. My personal conviction is that this is about the unconscious, really. By shuffling the cards, by picking the cards, and mostly by interpreting them, our unconscious minds, we tap into this vast flow that our unconscious minds create, and they can even merge to some degree and produce something like the collective unconscious, where we really where it merges and where we just gain more knowledge than we usually have. So it's interesting to see that it's really about relationships, and specifically this card really tells me that you are now at this point where you can actively access this knowledge, and where you really have this bravery to go real deep with this knowledge and really go down to the heart of the matter. And of course sometimes the truth hurts, sometimes we don't really want to see, but I can only applaud you on going there and really wanting to know. And as this card now tells me, it's especially when you're just falling in love or planning to move the relationship to the next step, or maybe breaking apart, somehow changing your relationship with that other special person this is about, then it's so important to really dig deep and really go there. And somehow I get this weird impression that I don't know what exactly it is, but it has to do with this red or maybe green shirt, maybe a cloak, perhaps it's black and white piece. Yes, that's it. That's exactly it. This bed you have in your room. Something about it just doesn't quite feel. Maybe you just want to look into that. Maybe you just want to play around with the energies there and experiment a bit. And let's look at the next card. And okay, so this is not only about chaos and confusion, it's also about order, and it's about a huge transition, like maybe like a journey, but maybe also like the journey of your life that you're about to share with this other person. And really this change is so important for you. And really I can only reassure you, deep down you are prepared to deal with all these mixed up feelings and this rather strong stuff that's going on in your life. And you will certainly, find this kind of hero, maybe on the outside, maybe on the inside, maybe it's like more like your own unconscious preparing you, guiding you, helping you, and finally you see this guidance really getting through in your life and making you so happy. So ultimately I can only tell you that this is really a good thing and you're going in the right direction. And yeah, that's
So,
very
were
good.
you duly impressed?
Actually, I certainly hope you were not impressed that much. By this little demonstration of my tarot card reading skills. I don't fancy myself a particularly good tarot reader, by the way. The thing is, back when I was actually doing tarot, I honestly believed this stuff. What I told you now, I would have actually told a client or a sitter, as they call them, this stuff about the unconscious that somehow produces meaning out of shuffling the cards and picking a card and interpreting the symbols on the card. I somehow actually believe that, even though at the same time I always had this little nagging voice in my head that says, it's just not quite right. I considered myself a very rational person at the time, you have to know, and I never really managed to believe it 100%, but I actually managed to believe it enough to sell that stuff, you know. I really did a few readings, not only at parties for friends, but I did some readings for money. I wasn't too successful, but you know, I did earn a bit of money that way. And I really honestly thought that this is a good thing and that I am somehow in some way helping people, or at least I wanted to believe that, you know. And if you want to believe something very strongly, you can manage to convince yourself to a degree that allows you to go on with it. I think that's how I would phrase it. You're not really 100% convinced, and you still have doubts, but you're convinced enough to make yourself believe that you're convinced enough to do it. Something like that. I think there is a strange loop of belief in belief, belief about belief, going on, and you just managed to somehow go on with it. And then something happened. At some point, I came across material about cold reading skills, and I do not remember exactly whether it was a book or it was on the internet. I think it was somehow in the context of communication skills, stuff like that. And then I slowly realized that, oh my goodness, this is exactly what I'm doing. You know, and maybe before I just use the term, I should try to tell you a bit about what cold reading actually is. There is enough stuff on the internet if you just Google it, but here are the three or four most important points from my perspective.